Hi everybody, Ed Diaz from Roland here. I'm here at Sam Ash and we're going to go through the Roland FA-06, FA-08 music workstation. So let's take a look at the sample section inside the FA-06, FA-08 music workstation from Roland. So we have these pads over here and this is where our sampler is. So let's take a listen to some of these samples very quickly. So check this out. When you're in a store, you can have some fun with some of these. So the way we have these set up in the demo models is all of these in each column are in sync with each other, or their tempo with each other. So I can have fun and maybe start the drums. Maybe bring in. So I have that going, but I can also press the hold button and have them hold for me. So this can be very, very fun. Now let's go into a little more detail and explain what it is. With inside the FA on the sampler section, if you press the bank button, you have four banks of 16 pads. So you can have up to 16 times four samples in here. Okay, I believe that's 64. So right in here. Now what kind of audio files can you use in this? Well, you can use WAVE and also MP3 files in here. Keep in mind that the FA-06, FA-08 do come with a 4 GB SD card. Now, 4 GB might not sound like a lot by today's standards because gigabyte flash drives and SD cards are just all over the place. But let's take a listen. Let's think about this. 1 minute of stereo audio at 16-bit, and we did 16-bit because that is CD quality and that is still the most common bit that's out there. So 1 minute of stereo audio at 16-bit equals approximately 10 MB. 10 MB. So 1 gig is 1,000 MB. 4 gigs is 4,000 MB. So what's the math there? So 4 gigs equals approximately 400 minutes of sample time. 400 minutes. So right out of the box, you have plenty of room to go ahead and load up a ton of samples. So this is a lot of fun. Now let's talk about sampling on here. How easy or how hard is it? Let me choose this bank. If I wanted to sample in here, that means bring in audio from other places. One way I could do it is take my SD card, put it in my computer, and there's an import folder in there, and I can drop in samples that way and assign them to the pads. We have different inputs in the back here. We have an 1/8-inch stereo, which means you can put in your iOS device or anything else that has an 1/8-inch stereo jack. Plug it in there. You can also plug in a guitar in here as well and sample it into the keyboard. It's very easy to do. I'll show you very quickly. I just hit sampling and I just choose what pad I want. If a sample already lives there, it's going to tell you, hey, do you want to overwrite this? I'm going to say yeah. Now I get the choice. On the screen, I can choose the input that I mentioned earlier or the keyboard or keyboard plus input, and you can choose which input you're using. And then I can choose whether if it's a stereo or a mono sample, and then I can tell it to auto trigger. So once it gets a signal, any kind of sound, it's going to start recording. Or I can go ahead and press start and stop on my own.